Hey everybody, this is GTB.
And this is Bogowski.
Welcome back to the Very Hard Karma Run tutorial. As we said before, be sure to check the description for all the pointers and clear time and that for the end of the chapter. One thing that's great about this chapter for Very Hard, though, you really don't have to worry too much about the time limit, because you have ages. It's one of the really nice things about the higher difficulties. So I'll be saving quite a bit in this chapter. It's a really short time limit, this first fight, though. It doesn't leave you a lot.
Yeah, that is. I scoop them both up and then charge.
I don't think I tried that. I don't think that works on Very Hard.
Well, you're not as good as me.
You've only got the... well, if your level 1 Dragon Sword is killing Black Captain guys, you're not playing on Very Hard. Right, so here, that's a really important jump to make. You want Ryu's right foot to be right in line with that pillar near the doorframe, and then you should get a one hitter there. And then you can just smoke bomb and jump back here. Now, one thing I wanted to mention, actually, it's been a while since I've done these videos. We're trailing a little bit, unfortunately. But I did go back and watch a couple of them. Chapters 3, 4, and 5 are actually new high scores for the chapters. For some reason, I just got really stubborn and wanted to get the high score. I do not keep that up throughout the run. As soon as I got to chapter 6, I thought, to hell with this, because I just hate those chapters on a run. So right here, take this as more of a pattern on how to do the chapter. You know, if you're new, don't try and go for these patterns, because they're kind of insane. Just doing these three chapters added on like 30 hours to this run, because I just got super stubborn and wanted the best pattern possible. Don't do that. I don't recommend doing that at all, because it's very annoying.
It's such a relief to go from hard. This chapter, the time limit on this on hard is so hard to make sometimes, and to go to, I can relax and save, and
I mean,
takes a little pressure off.
I kind of mess about a bit on a lot of this stuff. Like, my movement's not really that quick, and I still finish with over 2.5 minutes left in this chapter.
Oh, wow, nice.
You have so much time. And it is one of the nice things about the high difficulties, but of course, it also goes hand in hand with the encounters. Because you have so much time, you've got a lot of time to kind of mess with. This fight's a perfect example. This looks great. I mean, this looks like you could... If you're watching this, you think, oh, okay, yeah, just smoke bomb. Kill him. Yeah, we'll kill him. Kill this guy. He'll give us a blue. You can already guess what happens on the 50 billion runs of this you didn't see. That guy won't give you a blue. They'll spawn on the other window. They'll shoot you out of your ET. That won't hit him. You'll hit the freaking bed instead of the captain guy. There's a glitch that happens here where if you roll back and forth twice, sometimes without flipping the camera, you will just go completely out of bounds in the game and you have to restart. Like, you just completely break the game. That happened to me once. That black captain guy can shoot you on this on landing. And it's literally for an extra ET. That's all I get extra out of that, is that first ET. But it takes so long.
And you only beat that time limit by like 1/100 of a second.
Yeah, it's super, super close. I don't know why I got it in my head to go for the top scores on these chapters.
Why are you coming back up this way? Why didn't you go through the door?
Did I go through the door? I can't remember. I was just watching that. I was literally just watching that and didn't even notice.
Hey, at least you're consistent.
See, this is why the harder difficulties are great. You don't have to worry about that shit.
Yeah, you don't have to, yeah, there you go.
Take the long way around.
Hey, real quick, before this one starts, on that second fight, is there any way the guys spawn from either side?
Oh, with the Grenadier and the Captain guy.
Well, here, hold on. We'll wait. We'll talk about it later.
This fight is a lot less stressful than the normal run. You can just smoke bomb here. You can chain essence to this fight if you want. But with having to get those other fights how you need it, to chain essence to this fight is a pretty insane gauntlet. And this fight is relatively straightforward, but it only really takes like one of your UTs to get stuffed, which can happen quite easily. And then, you know, you're going to be completely screwed. And then you have to go and get, you know, that insane pattern again, you know, on the other fight. So I just like to go and save after that and just start off with that UT.
That's so good control over you right there. That if you didn't ET both of those guys, you know, where I might have jumped one way and only got one ET because the other guy would have been so far away, but how you rolled one way, jumped the other to make sure you connected on that. That's what it takes to get that extra ET and those scores. Yeah. That stuff adds up.
really important. Make sure you pick up your counterattacks here. I want to say that if you forget them, I'm pretty sure you can still buy them from Muramasa, but I didn't actually go and test that. But I think you can still do that. But again, you have a lot of time, so just make sure you don't forget them, because you do actually need counterattacks. They're very important on a Karma run.
What I was saying is on the second fight after the game, when after the first encounter, you go out. And you know, the guys can come in from the windows on either side. Is there a way they only came out on one side for you? Is it because you stay so close to a window, or is that just something that's random?
That's a good question. Okay. I don't know. Because I had plenty of runs of that where, like, I got everything. I had my last UT good to go, and the motherfucker came in from the other window, and like that was it. It's like, okay, great. I have no idea what controls that. it does seem to be random, but yeah, I really don't know if there's something you can do to actually make it a bit better. Now, this is something I'm actually glad I really got on video. This fight was actually really tough to get the pattern that I wanted. A lot of stuff can go wrong, as always in these encounters, but the reason the ender of this fight is really important is for a while, I think it was probably only because of the footage at the time, really, but I think it was like 4.6 or 4.7 seconds was usually like the absolute maximum time we thought you could land an ET, a UT on a make the time limit. It's actually 4.28. I went back and checked that and went like frame by frame to look at the clock, and that UT connected on 4.28 seconds. So that's literally like a half a second more time than previously thought, you know, to actually make a time limit. As you can see there, I get
right on zero.
Yeah, like you get 8,000, and from what I can tell, the game will always round up, you know, to the nearest number on the kill bonus. So if you're getting literally the bare minimum, you know, you are finishing it on like, you know, 0.00000 whatever one of a second to actually get that kill bonus. So that's cool. It's cool to find that. And again, like, you know, back in the day, you know, good old 240p or whatever it was, you could barely make out the numbers, so you couldn't really see them that clearly.
How many times did you get lasered off with the helicopters the first time you saw them?
The first time I played very hard, I remember I did the crank, and then I just jumped on the wire and then got lasered off. I was like, oh, okay. I guess they're here on very hard. And the exploding bats as well got killed by them.
Oh, yeah. That was great.
I think I've told this story before, but I was watching my friend play this on very hard for the first time. And it's kind of a scumbag move, but intentionally didn't tell him about the exploding bats. So he opened the chest and he just got blown off the airship. And I just sat there just laughing. Thinking, yeah, I could have told you about that, but where would the fun of that have been? So this fight's fairly straightforward as far as getting this guy to come to you. Fortunately, you actually get two guys here on Very Hard Master Ninja. So more often than not, you know, one will spawn at the front, one will spawn at the back. The reason I swapped to smoke bombs there is because sometimes this guy can actually be quite far back here. He can be behind, like, right behind this window, basically where he is now. If he is, just smoke bomb and then forward Y so you don't have to break his guard. If you have to break his guard and he's that far back, you won't have time to get two UTs.
I guess there's the invisible line there that they can't cross.
It is. It's not on screen at the moment, but do you see where the little kind of plating is, what I'm standing on now? Yeah, as long as you're past that, they won't come to Ryu. And you really want to kill those with UTs, as it's important for your essence bonus. One thing that I can't remember if you mentioned it in the other videos, but smoke bombs on the higher difficulties are quite expensive. I think they're 600 apiece on very hard, and I think they're 900 apiece on Master Ninja. That seems too high, but might be 400 and 600. But like a full stock of smoke bombs is very expensive. You know, it's going to be over 5-6 grand. So in these shorter chapters where you really don't have a lot of money, taking advantage of stuff like that is really important, because ideally you really want to always try and fill up on some smoke bombs before the end of a chapter.
Do you get more essence for the exploding bats versus regular bats?
I think they're worth the same.
Oh,
it's not a lot, but I think they're, as far as I can remember, I think they're worth the same. So I come back and save at this safe spot, just because it's closer to, you know, where I'm going. You can save at the other one if you want, but it's nice to just be, you know, right here when you start in this fight.
You do this so good. I sit there and miss my time limit a couple times trying to traverse this. We talk about it every time we get to this section.
Don't forget your scarabs. It's very, very important to pick up your scarabs on very hard. Every major Nimpo upgrade, every major Nimpo you will get via scarab rewards. Spirit of the Devils, Jewel of the Demon Seals. So you really want to pick those up. Nimpo is super important on a Karma run. And if you're off on any of your scarabs, you know, that is... It wouldn't kill your run, but it would really hurt you in the later chapters.
That's another time limit you made exactly.
Yep. You can actually do that a little bit better. I think I did 3 back-to-back on-landing jumps. What you can do is do wind run, so it's like X plus A, and then just roll jump on landing. It doesn't sound like a lot, but you won't finish it like quite on the nail like I do right there. You'll have a little bit of time.
And saving at that spot that you saved at saves the long traversal.
I hate that about... There's one thing in Karma runs that really bugs me. You know when you have a fight to do, but before you do a fight, you have like 20, 30 seconds to get to the fight. You know, like it's just... Oh, it can really drain you a little bit.
Well, that one down the elevator in this chapter, those guys, especially on normal and hard, normals.
Exactly, yeah. If that flying swallow doesn't kill, you know, you have to restart. Yeah. Like, that's it. So this fight's pretty similar to how it is on the other difficulties. The one kind of, I don't know, fly in the ointment is this bloody Grenadier, because he loves to just kind of move from side to side every now and then, and sometimes he can get stuck, you know, on those little on these little bits here where I just flipped up. He can get stuck there, and Ryu's Lunar UT won't be able to connect on him. So that makes that a little bit trickier, you know. On normal and hard, like, that's super simple. Like, you just charge that UT, and because it's two white guys, they just stand there and let you hit them. That Grenadier can move about a bit and trigger the time limit, which is a bit annoying. So this fight right here is a really important thing. There's a bit of a there's a quick screen grab coming up. Unfortunately, Ryo's auto-targeting will target guys that are standing up over guys that are on the ground. So right here, you really want to make sure you wait until the guy is on his feet like he is in this picture. You can see the guy on the right is about to shoot me. So wait till he's on his feet, then let go of Y, and Ryu will target the one that is on the floor, not the one that dropped down.
Then, how'd you figure that out?
Just testing, because it was just really bugging me, him like attacking the wrong guy. And the reason you want to do that is because if you attack that guy with the that is not on the floor with that UT, and then you ET the other guy, if you hit him first, that ET will kill him, and then you can't flying swallow him and get a blue to come up here and get a UT and an ET.
And you said you beat the old very hard high score?
Yeah, not by much. Because I mean, some of these scores as well. I mean, for anyone wondering, I haven't done the like the titles for this, but Balbade holds the record for very hard, and there really isn't a whole lot of points left in some of these chapters. Some of these like really, really kind of rare patterns that you see. It's one of the reasons that did motivate me to do it, was because it is cool to see these patterns. You know, you don't really see the absolute rarest of patterns most of the time. And it's cool to see those on video. But that's about it, really. Looking at this realistically, in the second fight, you might be able to get an extra UT where I got an ET. But looking at the rest of the chapter, aside from doing what I do, but just doing it like a split second faster so you get like an extra few points on your kill bonus, I really can't think of many points left in this chapter that are actually attainable. My dynamo goes very, very well. Like, boss fights are always a bit odd working out like a maximum for, because on the higher difficulties you have the balancing act of their minions and UTs, and it's always a little bit, you know, it's always a little bit hard to work that out. But yeah, like,
so Inferno was the scarab reward.
Yeah, you definitely want to get Inferno. Get that before you go. I'm glad you mentioned that. Get that before you finish this chapter, because you definitely want that for the start of chapter 4. Yeah, I really like what they did with the scarab rewards on Very Hard. I kind of wish they'd done that on Master Ninja, because like it's a really deliberate choice. You know, like they really made a choice to stagger your Nimpo on Very Hard. You know, they don't give you all the Nimpo up front like they do on the other difficulties.
Right.
So Dynamo is a tricky one. If you just want to kill him, it, in a way, him having minions is good because you can smoke bomb and use the essence. Having a flying swallow one shot a white guy on very hard is very, very rare. I did get pretty lucky on this dynamo fight. I think this might have been my first or second run of this boss. Like, it just went really, really well. If he ground pounds, it's not the end of the world, unless he does it at really low health, because then he's going to have like the longest flurry of gunshots. When he does it at that, like it times it pretty well. Like, you just go and smoke bomb and UT him. And then you basically just want to kill the minions. Try and focus on the black guys to get UTs on him, drop your smoke bomb, and then just hit Dynamo with your UTs.
Oh, man.
It's funny when he shoots you and you're point blank. You're like, you bastard.
Was this a... I'm not going to use... Oh, there you go.
Okay, oh, no. I used that last one. Yeah, I didn't use it there because I thought, what's the point? So I actually get really lucky here. This is part of why this Dynamo is really good. That guy giving me a blue is just really good luck. That does happen sometimes. Those white guys will give you the little blue orbs. And that just gives me two UTs here instead of, you know, a UT and an ET. But again, you know, that's 3,000 points and that's a little bit of luck. So, you know, getting higher than the score, you know, I'd love to see it. Always love to see that shit because it's super entertaining. So time limit's 18 minutes and kills is 69. You basically have to kill everything. That's one thing to note on the higher difficulties. When you can't respawn enemies, make sure you kill all the minions with the boss, otherwise you'll fail your kill bonus.
Right.
And now it's everyone's favorite chapter. But that's it for chapter 3, guys. Hope you enjoyed it and we'll see you in the next one. Peace.
Take care, everyone.